We're going to have a look at an A-star level question on integration by substitution. So just to start with, we always tend to call what's in the bracket a singular letter. So let's let u equals x minus 2. Now, I'll show you later why we're doing this. But once you've done substitution, you want to replace everything that's in terms of x now in terms of u. So we can replace this inner bracket with u. How can we replace x though? Well, actually, if you rearrange the equation here, by adding 2 to both sides, we get that x is equal to u plus 2. So we can replace x with u plus 2. How do we replace dx? So it's in terms of u. Well, if you find du by dx, it will just be equal to 1, because when you differentiate x minus 2, x differentiates to 1, and minus 2 differentiates to 0. And multiplying both sides by dx, you get that du is equal to dx, meaning you can just replace dx with du. Combining all of this together, what we have now is x being replaced with u plus 2. This inner bracket here being replaced with just u to the power of 3 over 2 du. Now, why did we do that? Well, now that the power of 3 over 2 is only applied to a singular letter and this bracket has a power of 1, you can multiply out the brackets. In the previous example, when it was in terms of x, you can't multiply out the brackets because this bracket here is not a power of 1. That's what we did here by using substitution. Multiplying out the brackets now, u to the power of 1 multiplied by u to the 3 over 2, you add the powers together. 1 plus 3 over 2 is just 5 over 2, so we can say that's u to the power of 5 over 2, and then plus 2u to the power of 3 over 2 du. To integrate all of this, you integrate each of the terms individually. So when you're integrating, you're adding 1 to the power, so it becomes u to the 7 over 2, and you're dividing by that new power. Dividing by the fraction is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of that fraction. So it's the same as multiplying by 2 over 7. So I'm just going to write this out as 2 over 7, or 2u to the 7 over 2, all over 7. And then when you integrate u to the 3 over 2, similarly, it will be, well, u to the power of, add 1 to the power, and divide by that power, or 5 over 2, which is the same as multiplying by 2 over 5. So it becomes 2u to the 5 over 2 over 5. But then you have to take into account the 2 that you're multiplying to it beforehand. 2 times the 2 will get you 4. So I'm just going to write this all out as plus 4u to the power of 5 over 2 all over 5. Perfect. Now plus c. We're almost there now. Once you've integrated, you want to replace u again with what you introduced it as before. So we replace it with x minus 2. We get it's equal to 2 multiplied by x minus 2 to the power of 7 over 2 and all over 7, and you add on to that 4 multiplied by u again, which this time, well, again, it's x minus 2 all to the power of 5 over 2 all over 5 plus c. Now, this is all correct, but what we want to do is we want to compare it to the final answer. We see that there's a common denominator of 35 from both terms. So let's make both these fractions out of 35. You can multiply the top and bottom of this fraction by 5. So that becomes 10 lots of x minus 2 all to the power of 7 over 2 over 35. I'm not going to write over 35 here because I'm going to write a big fraction all over 35. Because once the denominators are the same, you can just add the numerators together. To make this second fraction out of 35, you multiply 7 to the bottom, so you also multiply 7 to the top. 4 times 7 is 28, so that becomes 28 lots of x minus 2 to the power of 5 over 2. Now, where we go from there is, well, you can notice that there's only a 2 outside of the bracket. So, focusing on only the numerator, you want to factor out 2. If you factor out 2, it becomes 2 lots of 5 x minus 2 all to the power of 7 over 2 plus, well, to go from 2 to 28, you multiply 14 x minus 2 to 5 over 2. So from here, it's just always comparing it to the final showdown answer and going as far as you can. And you can leave 2 over 35 there, plus the c still. The plus c is unaffected in the whole process. I'm going to do a little shaded line here. We're almost there now, but well, what we see is that these, well, how can we get to this from here? So straight off the bat, I can tell that both of these terms, we can actually factorize them because if we look into both these terms, x minus 2 to the power of 5 over 2 goes into both of them. So we can do 2 over 35, open bracket, one big bracket, with x minus 2 to the power of 5 over 2, which goes into both terms. And then to go from x minus 2 to the power of 5 over 2 to this first term, you multiply 5 and x minus 2. We add on to that, well, how do you go from x minus 2 to the power of 5 over 2 to this second term? Well, you multiply 14, and this times 1 just gets you to itself. So you can close the bracket here, and then plus c. This expands to 5x minus 10, just to save myself a bit of working out space. We're at 5x minus 10 plus 14. Minus 10 plus 14 is just plus 4. And so our final answer we get to is 2 over 35, x minus 2, all to the power of 5 over 2, and then multiply onto that, 5x plus 4, all plus c. That should be the final answer. Yeah, it's this here. I just wrote this term and this term the other way around. Hopefully that all makes sense. And actually, I'll link in the video the next part of the question, which goes through how this can be used in another part of the question. So look out for that, and yeah, I'll link in the description. Be sure to like the video if it helped, by the way. It's quite a difficult question.